It is International Bagpipe Day. So, if you want to learn playing the bagpipe, you don't have to buy a bagpipe. Just a practice chanter.
People ask me, how can you learn an instrument? It's easy. Just get an instrument, put it somewhere where you can see it, and where it's tuned. Where you just only thing you need to do is pick it up and play something. Whatever you have to do with it, put it in your hands. If you didn't do that for a week, then you will never learn to play an instrument. It must be.
I'll do it twice a week, on the Friday and the Saturday. And if we play on a Sunday, I do it on a Sunday as well.
You must be interested in doing
yeah.
Just once a day, 10 minutes, is enough to learn an instrument.
And you can learn it to have your fingers on the right position. And you have to learn blowing.
You're going to teach me to play the bagpipes.
Hey, okay? There's a hole on the back.
Yeah.
You can your thumb. Place your fingers flat, not like this.
Okay, I'll try it. Let's see.
So you've got the 1, 2, 3. Now you have to blow. Yeah, and it sounds like an duck. It is a cross fingering.
Where's snake?
Yes. And then you ping back. Three fingers back. And this one back. No. We tune it to B flat. After a few days practicing like a... Okay. Then you need the grace notes. There are three main grace notes.
Grace notes.
G, D, A. If you can do that, you can make doublings, you can make a lot of more.
But what's inside?
You blow up the...
Can you play it like this?
Yeah. Okay, this is the first thing you have to learn. After a year and you think, oh no, I didn't practice and I cannot play it, you don't have to buy a bagpipe. And you can go to a bagpipe band. That's a good thing to start. After the big bagpipes, you've heard that one, you've got border pipes.
It's not only difficult for yourself to pick it up and play, but also from everybody surrounding you, your neighbors and everybody, your dogs and your cats, they won't like it,
no.
I guess. So you really have to push it through to learn it. You need to ignore everybody and just don't give a damn about other people. That's how David is. That's the reason that he learned to play the bagpipes, because he doesn't care about other people. He doesn't mind if people are annoyed by the sound of the bagpipe.
You've got a bag, you've got a pump, and you've got reeds inside this. There is missing one.
Yeah, it's an easy drone, an easy.
There's no bag on the other pipe.
For in your living room, when you're watching television or something, then you can... and you're watching the television. Here's the back. You've got drones, three little drones.
The same with the fingers?
Same with the fingers.
And what do you get
and this one is standing in A. easier to play with.
Can I pump here and you can play it? You get the bagpipes and I pump and you play.
Then you play it on the other arm. Okay, now we're going to play.
Okay, I'm with him, Oh, I'm with him.
Yeah, like that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I noticed there is some coordination involved. It is not like just blowing this.
Unbalanced chicken.
Yeah, it's yeah. When you press here, you have to release here.
Yeah, and it has to be steady.
Yeah, the more you do here, the less you do over there on the other side. So you have to balance it out.
Okay. Yeah. And then we've got the other instrument.
Yes.
And this is a part of an ilium pipes. But this one functions as well.
That's the business part of it.
I cannot play anymore because I don't know enough about it to restore the reed. You can play in several keys.
Valves. Like on a saxophone valves.
Yeah. You can play chromatic.
The Irish ilium pipes.
Yeah.
And this has a much more softer sound than the other bagpipe. Maybe you can play a small melody.
Yeah, and you have to put it on your knee every time. And you can close them.
You only need to lift it up with the lowest note.
Yeah.
Melody.
Which melody?
I don't know. The one we never perform on stage, but the one you're practicing all the time to learn to play the bagpipes.
Oh. I didn't play that for 2 years now, I think.
It's indeed. Yeah, that's why. Ooh, yeah,
That's warm.
That's a good practice.
I didn't play it for several years. Yeah, but you have to remember it. You have to play it.
You didn't, yeah. Need to sit on the other side because I was on your way. This is one of the bagpipes that's specially made for sessions in Ireland. I got only one question. How do you play two octaves? How do you play the other? Is it like overblowing? Oh, yeah. Is it like a whistle?
Yeah, it's
like a whistle. Like more.
You
more
have to press it a little bit harder, and then you've got the second octave. And but it's. Yeah, you have to practice it. You have to push harder, softer, harder, softer. Okay. You have to do a lot of
more
work with your other arm.
On the other bagpipes, you only need to be steady and play the notes. On this one, you also need to be unsteady.
Really unsteady.
To be able to get all the notes on the right moment, on the right place, in the right
time.
Time and in the right pitch.
Yeah.
Oh, that sounds complicated. David, please play the guitar. I played the bagpipe. D? Yeah?
So be easy and free when you're drinking with me. G.
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 Okay.
So be easy and free when you're drinking with me. I'm a man you won't meet every day.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, now I'm going to play the bagpipes. Okay, let's see you next week.
I had my first guitar lesson here. Really, really nice.
How do I start? This way. The left one, yeah. And oh, you need to blow this one. Push! See you next week. Bye.